So before starting with the demo, I just want to refresh some of the navigation commands and toolbars we're going to use. So something that I will be using quite often is going to be the zoom in option. I'm not going to use the buttons at the top, which is also an option, but I'm going to use the right click and zoom in going up or out, going down. Moving the molecule, we just click and rotate it. If we want to rotate it in the plane, shift and rotate. And if we want to move it, Control plus left click and position it wherever we want it. To change the style, which I might also do, I can go to Display, Styles, and select the style from the list here. I'm not going to change any setting today, but just a reminder, they're here. But I'm more likely to do it from Style and select from the drop-down menu. So now I have selected Ball and Stick. Another thing, we will be using the Display Option toolbar. You can use the Reset button, which, as a reminder, it will bring again to the original initial position. And now I have to move it again. And we will use also the More Info for learning more about the structure. And I have already used the Structure Navigator, so where we have all the list of ref code, to select the ref code that we're using today. And the ref code is TIRDOP. So to start with the Mogul Geometry Check, I need access to my Mogul. Okay, here it is, to the CSD Core menu. So we click CSD Core menu and we go to Mogul Geometry Check. We have this pop-up window here, which you've already seen. So we can select the fragment type. And for sake of time, I'm not going to be analyzing rings for this molecule. And we can select filter options for these. So I'm not going to apply any for this run, but to just have a look at what we could do. So we can apply filters. We have our factors, so we have different options available from the drop-down menu. We could exclude solvents or non-solvents. We can select the heaviest element. There is a long list here. We can exclude organometallics or organic structures. And again, we could exclude powder structures. For this example, I'm not going to apply any filter. We could also select some other options in the search mode, but we're going to keep the default. And as Susanna showed us, we could customize the fragment classification here. So we could select the values for the unusual definition from here. And again, I will keep the default. So, okay, I would just need to click search now. I get a warning, which is telling me that I've not selected any part of the molecule, so it will run the check on the entire molecule. I'm happy with it, so I will do okay. Okay, so that was quite fast because I'm not analyzing rings. I want to change the shape of this table a bit. So what do we have on this table? We have a list of columns. So we have type of the fragment, we have the molecule, we have the fragment, the classification, the number of hits, the query value, the mean for that fragment, and then we have a list of statistics for that. As you can see for the bond, the Z-score is highlighted. So in terms of rows instead, we see they're divided by types. So we have the bonds fragment, first of all. We can see the molecule with the ref code, and then fragment by fragment, we can see the atoms involved, their classification, and all the values, as we said, as we saw before. And we can see again the color coding. So for not unusual with enough hits, and for unusual values with enough hits. I think for this example, we do not have any case with few hits. Okay, so I'm trying to move this on the side so we can see on the 3D viewer. some of these fragments. As you can see, when I click on the screen of the 3D viewer, my table disappeared. I can just find it again from the navigator here at the bottom. So that should be fine. Okay, so if I single click on any of the entries, I can see it highlighted on the molecule. So here we can see some of the bonds. You can see the angle here or here. Again, I'm rotating it a bit for better viewing. Here is my table again. So let's see some neutral here and some torsion as well. Okay. I increase the size of the labels. If you also want to do it, just a reminder, you can go to display, labels, label size. So I have it on 20. We could increase it if it helps a bit. Okay. So to deselect, because it's now getting a bit crowded here, we can just click again on each of the selected entries that we don't want to see anymore, or we can just deselect all the fragments, and this cleared it. Okay, so we want to have a closer look to one row in particular, one fragment in particular, and let's say we want to study this unusual fragment, the C5-C4 bond. So I clicked once so I can see it where it is on the molecule, and now I double click and I have the results viewer with the histogram. So in the x-axis of the histogram, we have the bond length, and in the y, we have the number of hits. So the bars contains the number of hits. The colors of the bars, so it depends on the CSD version and the updates. So you can see it in the box here, and you can also change the color of your update. And another thing that we need to remember is that the red line represents the values of our query, so of the bond in our molecule. So next we want to see the results in the view structure. So we can see all the hits from the view structure tab. So these might remind you of the conquest results viewer, if you're familiar with it. So we have the list of ref codes on the right hand side, and we can scroll through. In red, you can see highlighted the fragment. In this case, it's here, and it has two hits, so we can actually switch between the two. So you see it's here or here, and we can also see the 3D visualizer, where the fragment is highlighted with a different style and the values are shown here. We can also learn more information about the structure from the information tab, sorry. Okay, back to results and analysis. We can see, as Susanna showed us, the filters we applied here and some statistics of the results here. We can see the total hits and the selected hits. So this is because we can also deselect. So if we just click on either the squares, whatever rectangles, more squares at the bottom or on the bars, we can deselect them. We can click and drag and select more of them. We can deselect all from the deselect options here, or select all again here. So if we select, okay, let's deselect all and select just few columns, for example. In the view structures, we will see only the entries that we have currently selected. I think for this example, we want to see just one more thing. So let's reselect all the entries. We can see that we can apply the filters after. So for example, if we, so these are the same filters that we saw before. We could apply, for example, that the structures need to have an R factor smaller or equal to 5%. If we do okay, we can see it completely change the shape. So that's also something that we can do. Okay, perfect. So we can close this example And yeah, you could repeat the same analysis with any of the other entries of the table, of course. Another thing we can do, so let me close this and reset. As you remember, at the beginning we got a warning telling us we did not select any part of the molecule. So this is because you could actually run the Mogul geometry check on only a part of the molecule you're interested in. So let's change style to ball and stick, so it's a bit easier to visualize. So if we want to run a check only on a part, we would need to select it either before or after the warning. So to select, we can just click on each of the atoms we are interested in including in the analysis. Another way to do is to use the lasso, which you can find here. So you can just select lasso and circle the atoms you want to include. And you can see in the picking mode, it also changed to lasso. Or another way to access the lasso is using Alt from your keyboard and draw. So with this selected, when you next run the geometry check from CSD Core Mogul Geometry Check, we're happy with the same definition as before. You see, we didn't have the warning, and it was also quite fast because we have less fragments to check. And they correspond to the atoms that we selected. Okay, so last but not least, you can also launch Mogul from here. So CSD Core launch Mogul, and it is opening. Here it is. So you can see that what appears here is what we saw before. So we will have our histogram here with all the statistics and the view structure. So what we didn't pay attention to before is the build query part. So where you can load or draw a molecule. And then here you would be able to select the fragment that that you want to analyze. This brings me to the end of the demo.